You can put this bike together by yourself, but it's much easier if you have a friend. First, let's open the bottom of the box. To do that, hold onto the box and turn it over. While the box is upside down, open the bottom of the box. Now you're going to want to flip the box over, making sure that the flaps are outside of the box. Grab the box and slide it up and over the bike. You'll see that all the parts are inside of the box. Carefully remove all of the components from the plastic so that you have it laid out in front of you. We'll be putting the front stabilizer bar on first. When putting the front stabilizer bar on, make sure that the wheels are pointed towards the front of the bike. Now we'll put the rear stabilizer bar on. Some bikes have alignment markings that you want to pay attention to. Next, we'll be installing the seat post. While holding the seat post in one hand, pull the pop pin with the other and slide the seat post in place. Your saddle might already be assembled to the seat post, but if it's not, now would be the time to put it together. Now we're going to install the handlebars. They go together in about the same way that you did the seat post. Grab the handlebars with one hand, pull the pop pin with the other, and slide it down into the frame. If your bike has fore aft adjustment on the handlebars, you can attach those bars using the adjustment knob. Now it's time to install the pedals. Take a close look at those pedals because they're marked left and right. The rule of thumb is that we tighten the pedals towards the front of the bike. Let's start with the right pedal. It tightens in a clockwise manner. Now let's move on to the left. It tightens in a counterclockwise manner. Before riding your bike, you want to make sure that the bike is solid on all four feet. Congratulations, now your spinner bike is assembled.